Okay, it's just past 7 a.m. and we're getting prepped to take the tower down to change the antenna. Got some guys over there taking the bolts out. The truck has not come yet, the boom truck, so we'll pick up then. Okay, looks like the crane has showed up. That's the truck with the big boom that will get over top of our shack and let everything lower down. And of course someone's going to have to climb that tower quite a bit and hook a chain up to it. And the tower actually has a hinge on the bottom, so the tower can be lowered on essentially a hinge point. Repeater is now turning off at 9:07. Looks like we have somebody getting a climbing harness on. Okay, we're on our way up. The climber's got a rope attached onto him so he can pull essentially a strapping chain up. And a chain to strap onto the tower, as well as pull up the cable, I guess. So he's putting his safety harness around now. Actually, this isn't the cable itself. This is just a strap and a U-shaped hook, coupler. That the crane truck brought. I don't think we're gonna go up with the cable. Okay, there goes the cable for the tow truck, or the crane truck. I heard a click. Looks like we got a tight cable. Now it's time for the bolts to come off. When they get the base bolts off where the hinge is, then they'll be able to start tipping this thing over. Okay, they got the all the bolts off, so it should be coming down pretty soon. They'll pull on that little yellow rope that they tied on to tilt it. They're going to get out about a couple hundred feet. Yeah, maybe only a few feet. Oh, it's wiggling. They're yanking, they're getting over a good 60 feet out, and now they're pulling on that tower. There it goes. The crane truck is letting her down. Look at that! working great.
All turned off.
And the cable's now slack again. Looks like they put some tires down for the tower here to lay across this cement slab.
Yeah, he said he made his antenna, so he got his baseline.
It's not open. Unless we've got it open.
Now we have just a crew of people going at it.
That's what we wanted to hear.
That's in the work Drive. Right. Okay.
We're taking the hard line off.
We're taking these off, right, Larry? Huh?
Yeah, these are coming off. We have to take this helix off of here. We're going to have a piece of coax going down.
This is the old antenna.
Yeah.
This is the...
We can make that go away.
This doesn't look like it's in too bad a shape, really.
We can make that go away.
Okay, we got to get that connector
off. Whole crew of guys taking this thing.
Right here. There's the bad spot.
We got to cut this open.
We got a knife.
Off? Yes.
Power's off.
Total power down.
Watch Terry's hair curl.
No, arc the blade on the hacksaw.
We need to cut off all the tape on that connector.
We need to get
this right?
Whole piece of helix off of the thing right now.
So lots of activity.
Hold the strap.
What size?
Why don't you leave this?
This will take care of that. We can let that flap.
Okay, go on. Good. Go.
We'll take it off. Yeah.
Close up of the strapping. There's the cable.
Maybe I did bring a pair.
That's why they let you talk.
And this is how the tower hinges, right there. It's got double bolts on this one side and then a single bolt on the other here. And that just hinges over. Couldn't be simpler. And they left enough slack in this hard line so that this thing can flex and go over
I
on the side.
I like the 10 steps, but I gotta lower it.
This will make noise. This will make noise, so we need to get rid of this problem.
And this is just a hard line they cut through, huh?
Yeah.
And so it's a plastic on the outside, copper right after that, some insulated material.
Same thing as plastic
cladding, and then a hard copper line in the center.
I tell you what.
And they cut it right here because there's a big dent right there.
Why don't we
big
use
bad
one
dent. I'm not sure how they're going to reconnect that though. How they plan on reconnecting this hard line to the top?
We're going to put a connector here.
We've got a destroyed host clamp right over there.
Want to try this?
And having a
having a not having a hard line all the way to the top won't cause problems?
You got 15 feet. You got 1 dB or 2 dB per 100.
This clamp is coming apart altogether, so it'll be a lot easier.
0.2, 0.3. Yeah.
So no big deal to replace that last little 20 feet of hard line. We made short work of stripping this tower down and getting the antenna off. And the hard line where it got damaged is now also getting fixed. Here comes the new antenna. Commercial.
Done.
Let me get this.
It's probably still on the one you just hauled out of here.
Okay, now we got
assemble all the hardware and then slide it on.
Yep.
That's the main. I'm
going to move
lock washer
up about an inch, get the clearance on the ground radius.
Yeah, right there, perfect.
Okay.
Yeah. Here. Well, here, you do that one. I'll do this one.
Okay.
You're standing down. There you go.
So that's the clamps to hold the antenna to the
pipe.
The mast.
To the mast.
The mast. Okay.
Crimson
or what?
Yeah, it was pretty. And you go up there and
talk
about
AC unit. You stole the copper.
The mast to the antenna is bolted on now. Good to go. Now they got two.
We had a 4-4 building in Philly.
You don't have to hook into that bottom.
It's metric.
It's metric. That's
a new killer, huh?
Get you where you gotta go.
What about, how are you gonna do it?
Terry was telling me.
Okay. We have here.
We've got to use the connector in there because why?
Because
we don't have another one with us.
Oh. That's it, but it should be good.
Well, that would get used farther down where you patched it, right?
It's well preserved. Wally, do you still have your...
That would go down to where the patch was?
I got the...
Got it.
It doesn't cut and it doesn't...
It looks like it's hard to get to that adapter for the hard line.
But yeah.
Oh, this is
a... What'd you call that adapter, Terry?
What, hard line?
Hardline adapter?
That's a hardline connector.
To, right to the. Well, is it an end under there?
It probably an end. We do not.
All right, Terry, it's up to you. I don't know how to,
okay.
I don't know how to get
I'm
that off.
I'm looking for a couple of big wrenches. Now.
There, now they need to get that off. Put it down after where they cut it.
An end connector on that end and a hardline connector on the other end.
Now we're going to do the
what?
Oh. We're patching onto the hard line with an adapter to end connector.
Hard line to UHF end connector.
Got it.
Center of UHF connector screws into hollow copper tube of hard line.
Okay. Got it.
And in my truck, I've got a good razor knife. Although my pocket knife is sharp.
Here's mine.
You got a good razor knife? Bring it on. Done. Now. Yeah. Good. Just like we. You grease the roll ring and. I would say I've got it in the right slot from the looks of things here.
Looks like it.
You want to get right here?
That's good. Now, name of the game is you want to flare. Actually, what I want to do, since we're in good shape here, is I want to cut just a little more off this shield because I'm going to flare that copper out to this edge.
When?
Well, you know,
because now's the time.
No,
good surgery here, Terry.
He's done this once or twice.
Yeah, I think he's done that a couple times before.
15, 20 years, hasn't it?
He actually wonderful, but there's a couple new things to pay attention to when you're working with it.
I think at least once every year or every other year.
Well, we could plan 2 years from now to do some maintenance and really make a plan out of it and get some of this stuff corrected.
Yeah.
And by flaring that shield around here, this inside edge of this is in fact an angle, and the edge here inside is also a flare. So it ends up clamping the flare.
It's in time in UHF.
Okay, I would say we're in good shape there. Next comes center pin. And we're going to give just a smidge of lubrication to that. Doesn't make a lot of difference, it just makes life a little teeny bit easier.
Yeah, these?
Yeah,
right down to Home Depot.
And here is my wrench to screw it into. Yeah, I pulled out here once. Having a lot of top end. We are in route, folks. Center conductor is connected. No solder required. Done. Okay, we're looking happy here.
Want more grease? This is to keep oxygen and moisture out.
Yeah, I'll just throw a little bit right up here.
Gives you a good electrical connection.
Yeah.
I'd like to see it.
The conductor?
It's great for tail lights and trailers.
Yeah. Antioxidant.
That's a good idea. What's it called?
Going down into the water.
Yeah, good.
What's the group called? By that time? Maybe by then.
Disaster guy?
That's where I got it.
We're going together!
Okay. On the internet, disasterguy.com. What's the right where I get the paint, too. Probably what it looks
like in about 50 miles.
Yeah, I found a play. Cool.
You want some of these eventually?
Did you have hardline all the way up before?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was deep down there.
We are connectorized.
Here we go. We're done.
Put
some of that in here.
Around. I need videos to show my wife the
camera. A little bit of
conductive grease, I guess.
No corrosion grease.
No corrosion grease. Oh, okay. It doesn't have good electrical properties.
No. You don't care. You're after anti-corrosion.
But it doesn't interfere with electrical conductivity? You can't.
Okay. Those who want to know what an end connector looks like, there you go.
I don't know how. Oh, you need to put bail in on
four.
There.
Well,
I'm just wondering if that's laundry, man.
Oh, hell.
Rolled up at this
we'll
end.
Screw it under here. Yeah. Okay. Did we grease that before we put it on?
No, we're going to have to grease it.
Okay, pull it off so we can grease it.
Terry, when you get to where you need it, I got steel tie wrap.
Now, this is the
excellent.
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 Is it diamond made? Is it diamond?
I don't know.
Antenna? Yeah.
The antenna.
No, the antenna's not.
You know who makes it?
No, it's Connor, I think. Diamond. Yeah, it is diamond.
Oh, okay. Well, diamond antenna. Is that the model? The.
Let's see.
X500 HNA, made in Japan. So this one, these go down at an angle, these ground planes.
That's just fine like they are.
Is that okay, design, I guess?
Just a smidgen. Yeah, just a real easy snug. Just a smidgen of that around here for future reference.
For the next climber, huh?
Right.
Hold that tape.
Think we need
say the tape, they say in the directions to tape.
Okay, well, let's do it then.
Radio on the output. If you guys think of anything, just give me a shout on the radio. W7JEZ. I'm on the way over to the Home Depot.
Coming up, got it right here.
Their Mickey Mouse mask, which is actually Gold 19 feet.
19 foot mast. How long is the antenna?
It's 18 feet.
18 something. And the tower?
Measure the tower.
What was the tower?
We have 15 feet.
How high?
37.9
for the tower. Okay, so you can do the math from there.
You got any silicone in your box, Terry?
No.
No.
We want for it.
Right there.
Doctor of math. Yep. She could hit anybody with a piece of chalk or her shoe. First shot.
It's sealed.
And that's just a collar to keep it from getting water and stuff in there, right?
Right.
Did it spur you on to learn French?
No, those are all stainless. I wouldn't even worry about them.
Learning French in high school.
Yeah.
Morse code eluded me.
That's home for a nap.
That part of my brain.
I'm going to check my language here. Somebody else.
Gentle snug. If they'll fit that big around, they probably won't.
They probably
don't much care.
Yeah.
Just gentle snug.
I found
the directions also said to put a loop in. Don't know why. About a 6-inch hole.
Okay. Let's verify our length plenty to get to the connector. Unroll the coax.
Now we got to have a, we should have a coil at the bottom.
We're going to do so.
Yeah, all right.
I'm just verifying we've got more than enough coax.
Yes, sir. Right.
So we can live without the loop. We got bags of coax. Good.
Let it come this way.
My car.
About like so?
Yep.
Doing that with tape or a metal clamp?
Metal hose clamp or metal wire. That's enough. Whoa, we're not quite tight yet. Don't want to get real tight.
Now we should actually bring this under here, shouldn't we?
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, that's all right. We have another clamp right there.
Okay, so that's happy. We loctited that? Yes. Good.
We are not going to clamp
any of this cable. We're going to do a lazy wrap.
Yeah.
This coil here is for what?
Well,
this loop.
The loop is if you look at the frequencies that we're running at, this becomes significant RF-wise, and it just helps the antenna with matching issues. Yeah, it cuts down on RF current on the shields that shouldn't be there. But if you take a look at any of the UHF antennas, they specify, and there's an approximate distance. Terry's got it about right. You can measure it, but it doesn't have to be precise.
Yeah, I guess. He's getting it, I guess.
Got all the hard lines back and ready to go.
Start on this.
Yeah.
In person, there's a lot of connection.
Now then. This isn't my tool. I've never used it before.
How long have you had the tool you've never used?
I've never used this tool before.
How long have you had the tool you never used?
Since about 6 o'clock yesterday afternoon.
Oh, okay. Well, that's not so bad.
That can't be doing anything. Ah, I see.
It looks like it might be. Those things were actually kind of cool. That would be my telephoto.
That get crimped, gets crimped on or?
Correct. There's a little teeny hole right there that would facilitate soldering if we wanted to use it. Uh-huh. We're just going to crimp it. We're not going to worry about it. The jaws on this device.
I can't solder that.
You got a sleeve down here, Terry.
That's where I put it.
Sleeve down. Okay.
He's crimping the center conductor right now, it looks like.
Correct. Put that on there. And these things can be stubborn. That's why they make a release trip on the crimp. We're very well solidly crimped, no problem. So now what we're going to do is spread the jack of the braid out a little bit. Then we're going to take the connector.
Got it.
This goes into here, slides over the braid.
Under the braid.
Well, the connector goes over the braid, or the shield, foil.
Foil, there you go, foil.
You want the tip to be right there, just like it is. The braid comes down.
We found the head and the tail, nothing in between.
I found yesterday, I came home and went out to the pool to check the pump.
They could be ornery, but if you talk to them right, they'll listen to you.
Get a drink and fill in and get back out or something.
The tip is right flush with that inner corn.
Actually, slightly reaching, slightly back. Just that much.
Okay. Another crimping tool.
At this point in time, we use back jaws on the crimper, which grabs the shield, and we're done.
Got it.
I'm going to put a little grease on there.
We'll put grease on the other side.
You already put grease there.
Grease here. And I'm going to tape that before we put it on. I screwed up, actually, because some of these, neither one of these do. Some of these come with a little piece of black shrink sleeve that you put from here out to here. We're not going to worry about it because it didn't come with it, so the hell with it.
Hey, Terry, it's a good idea. You want to check it with your meter right here to make sure we're good to the antenna first?
Can't hurt a damn thing.
Where's your meter? Yeah. Oh, he left it over here.
Next, how do you roll your own cigarettes? Take two.
And since that's the end, take this adapter.
How he rolled that without even using his hands, I have no idea.
It was rolling for a while. It's been hanging dead in my mouth for about 10 minutes.
Oh.
One thing about roll your own, they don't have a lot of the chemicals in them to keep them going out, but they just keep on burning.
I like those little nylon.
So yours go out.
Mine go out.
Yeah.
Okay. We are going to test an antenna in a horizontal polarity, which may not be wonderful, but we'll find out. It looks very good on UHF at 441.8, 1.2. Going to VHF. Thank you. at 148.2, give it about a 1.075. As close to perfect as you can get. But we are horizontally polarized near the ground, so things will change when we get upstairs, but it's still going to be darn good.
Our cabling's good.
It's not going to be chills.
No, we're happy as hell. Mm-hmm. Okay, we are going together.
Black tape?
Yeah.
In my pocket.
Not a hard tighten, just tight.
Snug.
Yeah.
We go back, we need one person to direct. Robert, he said he had eight people here going.
Yeah.
He wants one person to join.
How about
that's going to be me. Yes,
black tape for the bro.
So many people.
We did it with one connector and didn't even screw up.
I'm impressed, Terry.
We got lucky.
Let's compare.
Put on some more of that double stick to itself stuff.
On the outside.
Out on top of the electrical tape. Got
yeah,
it.
Which is...
Okay, looks like they're ready to raise the tower up. So people are going to lift from the ground to get it up a little ways. And then the crane is just going to keep taking up the slack until it can get a good angle and pull all the way up. There we go. Just about vertical. A little shake, but looks stable. They're gonna put in the ground screws now, or the ground bolt, or the bolts for the hinge, and we're done. Someone's gonna climb up there and take the cable off, of course.